Why, hello there, everybody, and welcome to our Age of Strife auditions. If you're not familiar with Age of Strife or the audition process that we've been going along here, it's going to be a lot like Hardcore Heroes. Age of Strife is a new campaign coming up using a 2-point Neil rule system, and we can get into those details later. Right now, this is one of the 16 auditions we have for cast members coming up with Age of Strife, and today we have Tanner as our player. So, Tanner, would you like to introduce yourself a little bit?
Hey, my name's Tanner. I'm 19, currently going to Marshall University, sophomore year. In my spare time, I like to play Magic the Gathering competitively. This weekend, I'm actually going to regionals in Columbus. So.
Ooh, fantastic. Who are the regionals being run by? Is it just Wizards?
I think this one is Star City Games,
Cool.
which is one of the bigger retailers of Magic secondhand.
Is the secondhand scene pretty big in Magic these days?
Yeah, most people buy it through retailers or like that.
Is there any market for old cards still? Or is it
Yeah,
all new stuff?
a lot of the old cards are actually worth a good amount of money. It's according to which ones you have, really. Some of them can be outrageous in price.
I didn't know, because all the. From what I've seen, it sounds like Magic has a whole bunch of rule sets where you can't use older cards in it, and I don't know if that's accurate. Can you use old cards in competitive play?
There's different formats. There's standard, which is like the newest six sets, and then modern, which is from like fourth edition up, and then there's legacy, which is all the cards pretty much except a small ban list.
Modern is fourth edition and up?
I believe so.
Ooh, cool. Well, enough about that. Let's get into the application process. So, Tanner's going to make a character, and then we're going to do some role playing. And it's going to be about an hour and a half, unless he dies early or something like that. And you've got as much, you can devote as much of that time to character creation and as much of that time to role playing as you'd like. So, why don't we start? And why don't you roll me some stats? Go ahead and pick your rolling method, and we'll just do it.
Okay.
Nice.
Four, five, six, seven.
That is beautiful.
Super average and a four.
9, 9, 7, 8, 4, 9, 9.
That
Wow.
four.
Wow.
Right.
Are you going to keep them in order or are you going to rearrange?
I think I'm just going to rearrange them and put them in wherever.
All right.
So I'll probably do so I can try to put that four somewhere where it's not going to affect me too much. Let's go. What does four get? Think I'm gonna play a thief with these stats. Just
Okay.
ordinary thief, probably. Try to do some stuff. Nine. Play nine and probably charisma and dex. That takes out two of them. One, two.
I'm going to be playing some background music through tabletop audio. If it's too loud, you can change it at the gear icon, and lower the volume.
Okay. And a seven. So my stats down the line, it's going to be strength at seven, dex at nine, con at four, intelligence at nine, will at nine, charisma at nine, perception at eight.
Cool.
Okay. Go through and fill my stats in.
Actually, could you give me those numbers one more time? I'm sorry.
Strength is seven, dex is nine, con is four, intelligence is nine, will is nine, charisma is nine, perception is eight.
Four con is an interesting choice.
I'm gonna see it more as I'm not threatening. I'm a fragile looking guy. I'm not threatening. I'm not gonna be the person that's gonna knock down your door.},                                        └          └└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└└
Mm-hmm. All right.
Doors four, number zero, dex. I think that's just zero all the way through with a nine. Yep. Four con. Let's see how much this hurts me. Negative one HP. Let's hope I don't roll one HP and instantly die. Intelligence is nine. 2 point goes. 12 is nine. Pretty much just zeros everywhere.
Yep.
What do I get for a perception of eight?
Nothing.
Just nothing. Zero and zero.
Yep.
Okay. Class is gonna be a thief. What's the races like in the area that I'm gonna be?
Whatever. We can put you wherever.
Okay. I'll probably just be human to make it easy. I'm not gonna wear any armor because I don't have any strength. Do I carry it? Can hold 20 pounds on me?
That is not great.
Nope. Okay, I get 2 weapon proficiencies and is it non-weapon proficiencies plus languages? Is that what it is for none?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I get 5 non-weapon proficiencies. Let's go with that.
So what are you thinking for non-weapon proficiencies?
I think my guy is not going to be the one actually going in to steal. He might be the one that helps organize. He might go in and stake out the place for his group of thieves that he talks to.
Hmm. Okay.
He might. So I'm thinking stuff like etiquette, stuff like that, so I can seem presentable to the people we're going to be stealing from, like show that I have might fake some wealth with me. Etiquette, which is charisma 0. Let me get appraising. It's 2 down. Let's do heraldry. Zero. Another good red ones. Save local history. Charisma, which is fine. I get 1 more. Let's do artistic ability. Let's be a painter.
Painter?
Mm-hmm.
You turn thief or you steal in priceless painting artifacts?
I think I use my ability as a painter to help get into places. Maybe I use the disguise of I'm a traveling painter, so I'm going to like the Lord's House offering to do like a mural of them or something.
Okay.
Weapon efficiencies. It's probably due. Is knife and dagger the same proficiency or no?
Sure. We can consider them the same proficiency.
Okay. Then probably a lightweight. I'll go with a sling. That's my other one. Something lightweight that I can use in case if I need. But hopefully I don't get into a fight. I'm gonna roll for gold. It's just 2d6 times 10. Mm-hmm. 80 gold, yeah, that's
very nice.
That's nice. Okay.
So if you're a painter who can do paintings for wealthy nobles, why do you need to steal things? Isn't that enough of an income for you?
I think with only 9 charisma, my paintings aren't the best. So I need to find another way. Like, they're passable, but it's hard to make a living off of them.
Okay.
Of a knife. Half a pound, that's good. How much do sling bolts weigh, like stones?
The bullets, well, I think they weigh like half a pound. No, I think the books has they weigh a tenth of a pound each.
Okay. Speed of my sling is 6. Okay. Takes a few seconds to wind up, I guess. Stone. Well, I have 10 stones. 10. The weight of a sling. Okay. Thief proficiencies, like they're stealing and stuff. Monks, traps. Silently hide in shadows. All right, let's go through this. 10. Okay. Humans don't get any bonuses to thieving adjustments,
they
right?
They get no bonuses to anything.
Sounds good. I get penalties for my minus for my 9 dex. So 0 chance of pickpockets.
0 is your base?
It's 15 minus 15 for my dex.
Oh, wow. You'll get another +5 for no armor, though. So that'll be nice in the end. But still, That's brutal.
Zero open locks, unless that's... Nope. Zero open locks.
Nice.
Trying to remove traps, I get negative 10 and negative 5 on opening traps.
Worst rogue ever.
Not gonna be the best rogue. Move silently, I get plus 10, but I get minus 20. So I get 0 move silently. It's helpful. Run shadows, I get minus 10. Plus 5. 0 hide in shadows, too. I can climb walls, though.
Nice.
All right. I still have 80 gold to spend, pretty much. That's a couple gold for the knife and sling. So how much would, like, some nice paints and a portrait board cost and stuff?
Like the board that you hold all the paint on and everything?
Yeah.
You want to spend, like, painting supplies are kind of expensive. Enough paint to do a proper portrait would probably cost you in the ballpark of, like, 10 gold.
Okay. So I'll take 10 gold for...
Including brushes and everything, yeah.
Okay. And how much would, that way?
2 pounds? No, okay. Probably a little bit more. Like 3 pounds for all the paints and everything.
Okay. And then, the canvas. How much for halfway decent canvas?
What size?
Something decent enough to hang over, like, a fireplace.
Okay. Canvas is pretty much just pulled skin over a light wood frame. So, let's say 2 pounds.
Okay. How much would that cost? It says paper's 2 gold in the book.
Yeah. Well, this is canvas, so it's going to be sheepskin, and it's going to be a larger bit of sheepskin. So let's say it's 5 gold for the canvas and frame.
Okay. Good thing I rolled pretty good on my gold.
Yeah.
Okay. Canvas. How much for some clay or putty?
How much putty and clay are we talking about?
Maybe just a handful.
If it's like clay, like potting clay, like 2 silver?
2 silver?
Yeah.
I'm gonna say that weighs about a half a pound.
Let's say 1 silver, yeah. 1 silver and a half pound.
Okay. What else do I need? Clothes in a backpack, is that 5 pounds?
Yep.
Can I throw a little bit of money to make them have, like, one ornate pair of clothings? Like, clothes?
Yeah, you can you can put as much money into your clothing as you'd like.
Okay. That makes a little more money. An embroidered robe is 20 gold. So... probably buy... say about 13, so it makes it even on my character sheet.
Nice. So 13 gold is quite a bit in clothes. Those are going to be quite nice.
Mm-hmm. I want them to be like the puffy pants and like the hat, then like a jacket.
Puffy pants, hat, and jacket?
Yeah.
Okay. Like the big puffy painter pants?
Yeah, the big puffy painter pants. Okay. That like get real tight on the legs. And down to like a nice pair of leather shoes.
Mm-hmm. And a painter's hat, or what sort of hat are you talking about?
Almost like Robin Hood's.
Ah, okay.
Cool. And I want to say they're green. Mm. A lot of gold. What else can I spend money on? Buy me a couple candles. She need a flint and steel to light candles, right? Or just have a torch nearby?
A torch nearby or flint and steel. Although I guess flint and steel would be a little hard to light a candle. I don't know how people lit candles, to be honest.
I'm just guessing like a torch is what I was thinking, or like the fireplace. That'd be close to get your hand in there. I'll figure it out. What else was it? With appraising, can I get a jeweler's loop or whatever it is, the little eye thing that jewelers have?
Yeah, that is going to be, it's not quite the price of a magnifying glass. I would say it's probably like a fifth the price of a magnifying glass because it's much, much smaller.
Mm-hmm.
I don't remember magnifying glass price off the top of my head.
A magnifying glass is 100 gold.
Ooh, that's expensive. So 20 gold?
Yeah, 20 gold on it.
Yeah. Can you afford that?
Yeah, I still have 50 left.
Oh, because you had 80 gold.
Yeah, I rolled crazy on my gold.
You're fine.
That, I'm guessing, doesn't weigh much.
No.
So I'm at 30 gold still. That's a good start. I think that's all I needed. How much for a ring? I want a
jewelry again. Can be any amount of money you want.
Okay.
You can have a one copper ring, then you can have a 100 GP ring.
Okay. What type of gem could I get for maybe 10 gold?
List of ornamental gems in the DMG. Let's take a look. Blue quartz, hematite, lapis lazuli, malachite, moss, agate, obsidian, tiger's eye, agate. I don't know what the hell these agates are. Turquoise, rhodochrosite. I don't know. Bunch of crap.
Just a ton of
small things that I've never heard of before.
Get me a 10 gold ring, but tiger's eye sounded cool.
Nice.
Sounds like a small one, look like a pretty good ring. Down to 20 gold ring. That's good for my gold. Languages, I get two, so common. Does thieves can't count as one?
Nope. That comes free.
Okay. And what other? I'm looking to probably be in a relatively big city.
Okay.
Where everybody doesn't know everybody's faces, pretty much. Somewhere where...
Okay, big city.
Mm-hmm. What's a...
Do you want a city name?
Sure.
Highport.
Okay. What else is in the population so I can get me one more language?
Halflings.
halflings everywhere?
They're like 10% of the population.
Okay.
Human dominated.
Okay. I guess I'm a halfling. One d6 for health.
Yep. Let's see it.
Let's be something good.
Nice. Beautiful.
Well, do I instantly die because my con is -1?
No. Yeah, you have 1 HP.
Just 1 HP.
Yeah.
All right. Let's hopefully I don't get hit.
Yeah.
Let's hope I don't get hit. No. Green eyes, luscious brown hair. First appearances is maybe rich. I'm guessing my art supplies probably stick out a little bit out of my bag.
Okay. Especially the canvas, yeah. Makes sense. Mm-hmm.
So when people look at me, they might recognize me as some type of painter. Let's go with... let's go with the prime age, like 21. That'll work. Name's gonna be Benjamin.
Benjamin.
What else do I need? Got my saving throws, got my encumbrance. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Three pounds of weapons, so 6, 7, 8. There we go. I'm not over my weight. I'm at 15.
Nice.
Level 1. Alignment, probably. Either neutral, or lawful evil, because he's looking to get rich. Just a simple get rich scheme. And I think that's about it.
Okay, can you give us a brief backstory of who you are?
My character is Benjamin. He grew up probably in one of the smaller cities outside of Highport. He was pretty much Eddie from Ed, Edd n Eddy. He always went around scamming people. That was what he was good at. He wasn't the best fighter or anything like that. Whenever he was faced with confrontation, he normally tried to run away or tried to talk his way out of it. Eventually he ended up picking up painting, probably from one of the elderly people in town. Found it as a good outlet for him to be creative with. After he gets a little bit of decent charisma, decent training with his painting, he decides to go to Highport to try to make it with the big thieves in Highport.
Okay. And what are your thief skills total?
Do I get a split 30 upon him, or is that at level 2?
60.
60? Okay. Sweet. And no more than 15 to 1?
Right. No more than 30 to 1.
Okay. I'm be 35 pickpockets, open locks is 0, traps is -5, move silently is 30, hide in shadows is 0, detect noise is 15, climb walls is 60, read languages is 0.
Yeah, so you put pretty much everything into move silently and pickpockets?
Yep.
Okay. Anything else that we need to know about your character? Why don't we go over his gear real quick again? What do you have on
him? Okay. He has a dagger and a sling. They're probably... Whenever he's in the rougher side of town, he might have his dagger at his side, but he normally keeps it in his backpack. He's very unthreatening. He's a scrawny little man. He has a relatively big backpack for his scrawny size, most notably his canvas that's like attached to his backpack. Inside there, he has some paints and some brushes to paint with. He has a little bit of clay with there too, in its own little bag. He's got 3 candles. He's got a nice tiger's ring, tiger's eye ring on his hand. He's got a jeweler's glass in his, probably in one of his pockets close by. And he's wearing fancy clothing, pretty much painter's pants and a Robin Hood hat with a nice green vest on him. And I still have 20 gold left.
Nice.
So that is Benjamin.
Cool. So Benjamin, we're gonna start off in Highport. It is a mild day. Weather's not too bad. Nothing really to write home about. You are hanging out in your favorite establishment, wherever that may be.
Probably one of the shadier parts. I probably have a non-fancy clothing, just so whenever I'm hanging down with the low people, like the commoners, mm-hmm. I'm not trying to stand out and be a target.
Okay. So what are you up to?
Can I roll my local history to try to see if I know how the nobles and such in the area?
Yes.
Would that be with that?
I think you probably already know that. You've been living in Highport for a while, I think.
Okay.
But speaking of which, can you go over your non-weapon proficiencies one more time for me?
Etiquette, appraising, heraldry, local history, and artistic ability, painter.
Sweet. So you already know all the big fancy nobles here.
Mm-hmm.
There's a bunch of them. This is the capital, after all. So, yeah.
All right. Is there any, like, how's the crime in the area? Is it organized?
It's pretty disorganized, and a lot of it.
A lot of crime.
At times, there have been various organized gangs. But they've all kind of fallen apart due to infighting, and now it's pretty scattered, which does make things actually a little bit more dangerous. You never know when you're going to run into someone else on the same job accidentally.
Okay. Well, I think I should just start right into it for a scam. I'm going to get my nice clothes on, and I'm going to head to one of the jewelers.
One of the jewelers in town?
Mm-hmm.
Sure. You make your way there.
Okay.
The jeweler is a human.
Mm-hmm.
She's kind of youngish for a jeweler, maybe mid-20s, maybe late-20s.
Okay.
And she's got kind of messy, frizzled hair. Looks like she's been hard at work all day and hasn't had a chance to pay attention to anything else going around.
Is there any windows in here? How did the door work? Was it just a modern door, or how is the doors locked?
Yes, it's a pretty standard door. It opens inside to the building. You don't see any wares on display out in the open room. It's actually just kind of a barren room with some drawings of some of the things that she's had done in the past, or some paintings. And then she's behind a counter working on something that's below the top of the counter. So you've got like a counter, and then there's it looks to be a shelf behind it, and she's working on something back there.
Okay. So I'll walk up to her desk. Hello, madam.
Yes. Hi. Hi, I didn't see you there. She puts down what she was working on.
You said she looked all distressed from working.
Yeah.
Been a hard day?
Well, it's been a bit of a day. Doesn't really show. Sorry. What can I help you with?
And I go to reach into my backpack. In one hand, I want to put a little bit of clay. Mm-hmm. Another hand, I want to put in my ring.
So, which hand has the clay in it?
I'm right-handed, so my left hand has the clay.
A little bit of clay in the left hand and ring on the right?
Yeah, and I don't want to make the clay obvious.
Okay.
Like, I want to hide it.
Sure.
I pull out the ring and I show it to her. My father just passed, and I'm running low on a little bit of cash, so I need to pawn one of his rings.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. That's tragic. Let me take a look at that for you.
I hand her the tiger's eye ring.
Sure. She takes it and begins to look at it, gets that little thingy, I don't know what you called it, out and starts examining it closely.
Mm-hmm.
Looks it over for a good while and hands it back to you, saying, well, I could probably give you 7 gold for this.
He told me one day it was one of his most prized possessions. He didn't have much.
I understand, but sentimental value doesn't have a price on the open market.
Okay. I'll take the 7 gold then.
Okay. She digs around and pulls out 7 gold coins and sets them one at a time on the table.
Okay. I pick them all up, put them in my bag.
Okay. She takes the ring and gives you a bright smile.
Thank you, madam. I turn to walk out the door.
Mm-hmm.
As I walk out the door, I kind of want to turn back and lean up against the door with the hand my clay is in, mm-hmm. and press it into the lock.
Mm. Okay.
And as I turn around, it's like, well, you don't work that much harder. Don't work too hard.
Well, maybe I won't after today. Thanks, man.
Give him a nod. And then I make sure the clay's in there nice, and I turn around to walk out.
Like, so you keep it shoved in the lock?
Yeah, like in a door, there's the little hole that the goes into. I'm trying to stop it from doing that, so if, when they go to lock at night, it won't lock.
Okay.
Cool. So after that, I'd like to probably head to go change my clothes. Where?
You must have somewhere in town that you live.
Okay. So I go back to my house and change my clothes. I probably take them off and get my lower class clothes.
Mm-hmm.
And right. I head to the tavern I probably frequent that has shady people in it.
Okay. You make it to the tavern. It is the same as it always is. Kind of dimly lit. Poor lighting from greasy windows that just no one ever cleans. There's a couple of mediocre performers, but they're being drowned out by the mumbles of other people around them. Their instruments aren't even really tuned all the way. Yeah, and here you are.
Yeah. Is there a group of friends that I've been talking to that might be in the bar?
Yeah. You have 2 friends in the bar. You can give them names if you'd like.
All right. So I walk up to one. Hey, Jeffrey.
Hey, Tom. What's your name? I forgot your name.
Benjamin.
Hey, Benjamin. How's it going?
Good. I'm looking for somebody. I have a duck that needs squawk.
All right. What's the deal?
I can come with, or I can give information on the place for a price.
What sort of mark are we talking?
The pretty lady with the gems.
Uh-huh. Okay.
I paid her a visit today.
Uh-huh.
Figured out a way we could get in.
Is there a timing for this window?
I'm just guessing at nighttime. I noticed a opening in her defenses.
Tonight?
That jackal.
This night?
Tonight. Yeah, we can do it tonight.
Like a hot deal. All right, so what's the breakdown?
I look at David, the other friend. Is he also interested?
He's a little bit more reserved, so he hasn't quite leaned in all the way. He's sitting in his chair, just listening, keeping an eye out.
I believe I have it so the door won't be locked tonight. So, looking for a couple, maybe, I don't know if there's a guard.
The two guys look at each other. Well, we might be able to swing that. One guard, jeweler shop?
Yep. On the little bit fancier side of town.
Usually guards are a problem. They ain't suckers.
I say, if the door's unlocked, we could probably be able to sneak in, sneak out, hopefully. Hopefully there's no one there. Do I remember, like, maybe a stool or anything that was sitting out of place whenever I was in the jewelry shop?
Stool?
Like, something like a guard would sit at.
Oh, I see what you mean. Why don't you make me a perception check?
Okay. Perception is 8. One of the not nines.
Oh, beautiful. Yes, you specifically do recall that there seemed to be like a pillow or something that you saw kind of hanging out from behind that counter where she was sitting, almost as if there might be like a cot back there.
Okay. She may live there though, so I'd rather not get her hands bloody. So she was relatively a nice woman.
All right. So what's the split here? Two of us take it, and three of us equal shares?
Equal shares, and I get my ring back.
Ring? Oh, that old one you found in the sewer?
Yeah, it was my icebreaker to be not noticeable in there as I talked to her.
All right. Are you coming with us?
Yeah, we'll wait till the sun sets.
All right. Sounds like a deal.
Okay. I wave to a bartender and orders all three of a beer.
All right, bartender comes over. You guys order some drinks, and you can kill time until nightfall.
Okay. So we kill time. Do I have to take off any silver pieces for the drinks?
Sure, take off 2.
All right. All right. So we're about to go out?
Yeah. Notes. All right. So that evening, when do you go? Do you go nighttime? Do you go evening?
Do I know the guards, how guards rotate in the town?
They don't have a strict rotation.
Okay.
It makes it too easy to track where they are when they are. So they kind of wander about.
At nighttime, is it places normally heavily guarded? It's like there's a lot of guards walking around, or is it pretty?
You're more likely to find armed guards, town guards, in the wealthier sections of town in the evening. Okay. So this area, which is a little bit on the upscale, is you know, if you're walking around in that area, you'll probably walk into or see a guard at some point, but there's nothing inherently suspicious about walking around at night.
Okay. So we probably go out a little after sunset, maybe around like 9-10. And we probably stay within the alleyways, try not to stay out in the main streets as much as we can. If we can, we'll walk up against the side of a building as we make it to the jeweler's house.
Okay. You take as many side streets as possible and make your way to the jeweler's house without having encountered any of the guards.
Okay. I didn't see any passing me or anything?
Mm-mm.
Okay. I tried to go to the back of the shop where I saw the cot was. Like, I tried to see if I could listen into through the back wall.
All right. Why don't you give me a detect noise for the back wall?
It's up 15%. That's a D100, right?
Yes.
Whew, 13.
Wow. Well, you put your ear to the wall and you hear something bumping against the wall.
Mm-hmm.
With like a very regular frequency. Like a bump, 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 bump.
I turn back to David and Jeffrey, probably both also hunched with their ears up against the wall. I think she's still awake. I hear what I believe a rocking chair.
Just one little girl, right? Against three scary knife-wielding men, huh? Come on. Can't be too hard.
Well...
we just gotta scare her a little, right?
Okay.
Run in there, make some loud noises, wave our knives around. Scare the crap out of the girl.
Does anybody have rope? As I look at both of them.
One of them has some.
Maybe we could just tie her up.
Yeah.
There we go. So here in a couple minutes pass and I make my way to the front door.
Okay. You get to the front door. Take a look down both sides of the alley. See no guards around.
I give the door check. See if it twists.
It does.
I look at both of them and I push open the door.
Okay.
And try to go in with the push.
You push open and the three of you slip in immediately. Do you leave the door open or do you close it behind you?
Make sure somebody shuts it, but try to be silent when we shut it.
Right. Door opens, you all slide in, door shuts. You hear a little bit of commotion. There's light in the room originating from a candle. And you see a human man in his mid-60s, sure enough, in a rocking chair, standing up with a start.
Does it look like he straight up noticed us?
Oh yeah, absolutely. In fact, I'm gonna ask you to roll for initiative.
All right.
I will keep track of your friends' initiatives.
Okay. I'd like to yell, which one of my friends looks bigger?
David. Wait, is that what you're yelling?
No, I was just asking which one of my friends looked bigger.
David.
I'd like to yell for David to get him. Like to go for him.
Okay. So the guy goes first. He and David go at roughly the same time. He draws a short sword and starts to yell, "Intruders! Help!" As David gets his knife out. Since they go at the same initiative speed, they just make attacks at each other. David rolls a 9, which gets stuck in the guy's leather.
He's wearing leather armor?
Yeah, you didn't see it when he was sitting down with just his chin up. But now that he's stood up, he is in leather. The armed man takes a short sword and stabs it towards David, who dodges gracefully away. It's now you and what's your other friend's name?
I think his name was was David and Jeffrey.
Jeffrey. All right.
Who gets their next move?
Is it me? Jeffrey goes next. He steps to the side, aims a dagger throw at the guy, and tosses his knife, which, of course, goes harmlessly to the side and clatters in the back, making a curse under his breath. Your turn.
I'd like to run out. So where's the counter at with all the...
The man is just beside and a little behind the counter. So the counter runs from the left side of the back wall. Well, from the left side of the wall, three quarters of the way across the room, and then there's like a little walkway. And the older guy is behind it, and David's in front of it, while Jeff is on the other side of the counter throwing like cross.
Okay. Is there a way for me to like hop over the counter?
Absolutely.
Like, and not get attacks opportunity or anything?
Yeah, totally.
Okay. I'd like to run, hop over the counter, and just, if I see Jules, just start putting them in my backpack.
You hop over the counter, you see a lot of tools and a lot of jewels that are like jewels and jewelry that are not finished that are being worked on. So there's like a coil of silver string, there's a bunch of like silver necklace things without anything attached to it, just the braid part of it.
Okay.
There are some gems that are like in vices that are being filed and being compared to one another. So there's a bunch of stuff lying about, but none of it's finished.
I'd grab the freestanding stuff, not the things in the vise that I have to take time to get out, as I try to move forward and look for more jewels or like rings.
Okay, let's roll initiative for next round.
Whew, 10 again.
All right, David goes for another stab with his dagger, scoring a natural 19, which is a single crit on our unnamed older gentleman. Oh, he drives his dagger all the way home into the guy's gut, who then slumps to the ground with a ooh. David is shaking a little bit. Jeff hops back on the other side of the counter and starts scooping gems alongside you.
Okay.
You hear a noise upstairs. It's your turn.
Whenever he stabs him and I see the blood, I probably take a second to stare at it, like surprised that we actually got hit him or whatever and actually drew blood. Then I just start filling in as many jewels as I can for this round if there's some in front of me. Mm-hmm. Just like I sit there with Jeffrey and we just fill it into our backpacks.
Okay. At the end of that round, a light comes down the staircase, which is just a little bit behind the counter, and starts kind of bouncing out into the room. You hear heavy footsteps, two sets of them. Or, I guess they're not heavy, but you hear footsteps in two sets of them.
I look at my two friends. How much jewels do I think we have? Like, a good amount, or?
Maybe like 30 or 40 gold worth. But you haven't found your ring yet. Let's roll initiative, and you tell me what you're doing.
Oh. It's the tens.
Oh my god. Tens all the way down. Okay, coming down the stairs is the same girl with the frizzled hair and a young man roughly the same age as her. She has a locked and loaded crossbow and points it out into the room and says, "Stop! Nobody move or I'll shoot!" The other guy's holding a lantern in one hand and has a knife, like a kitchen knife, in the other.
Okay.
She's in front, he's behind. They're on a stairway, so they're kind of, you know, stacked. Your friends turn to you and look for their next move.
How does it look? Am I behind everybody, or are they in front of me?
Towards
the stairs.
You and Jeff are beside one another, opening drawers and trying to find valuables. David is still standing over the dead man, a little bit in shock.
Probably with a knife in his hand still.
Uh-huh.
I make eye contact with Jeffrey and just get up and just jump over the table and start running with him.
Okay.
out towards the door.
Has a paired action on 50% chance you, 50% Jeffrey, on you, and she fires the crossbow as you
come on.
Go for the leap.
Come on now.
Three. It hits into a wall with a loud thud as you leap over the counter and away. And Jeff jumps over with you as well, and David turns on his heel and runs out. The woman starts reloading. You can hear it behind you, her cursing as she's like trying to find a bolt and put it in. And the shaking of the light tells you that the man has started to run out after you.
Just try to book it probably as deep as I can to the shady part of town, so maybe they're kind of scared and turn back.
Sure. The guy stops following pretty quickly, maybe 20 feet outside the building. And just kind of yells and shines the light. You hear people coming out, poking their heads out their doors and windows saying, "Shut up! Go to sleep!" Followed by, "Thief! Thief! Help!" Followed by, like, "Sound the guard!" And the whole neighborhood starts to wake up.
Is, all three of us together? Do we all three make it out, or did David get stuck?
No, you're all making it out.
Okay. We go probably to the shady end of town to find probably a unremarkable alleyway to counter Luton.
All right. You guys eventually make it to some miscellaneous alleyway. Your hearts are still racing. Yeah, take a look at what you got. It's dark. Do any of you guys have a light?
Is there a way that I could light my candle?
Yeah, I don't know how people lit candles back in the day, but they did. It was a thing.
Because if I could light it with my flint and tinder I bought.
Yeah,
is that how it'd go?
Sure.
Okay. I light the candle and I sit down and I empty my backpack of all the jewels and stuff that I managed to grab.
It's a flint and a fire stone, it sounds like. Which is before they had steel.
Okay.
Alright. So you guys light the candle, and by the little glow of the candlelight, you bring out the bits of silver and semi-precious stones that you found. It's not a lot. It's maybe 30, 40, maybe 50 gold worth of things if you were a jeweler selling it.
Mm-hmm.
If you sell it to a jeweler, you're probably going to only get 70% the price. Because they got to make their living too.
Can I roll an appraising to get about how much?
Yeah, absolutely.
Like a good exact check?
Yeah.
And I don't see my ring in it, do I?
No, you don't.
Up.
Oh, with a slash first.
There we go.
You're estimating the value of this is to be like 27 gold. It's not a great haul.
Yeah. I look at them. Do they seem unimpressed?
No, they seem pretty happy. They're patting each other on the back, except for David. I guess Jeff is patting both of you on the back, being like, "Yeah, guys, good steal, good haul." Jeff is standing there, dagger still in his hand, shaking a little bit. And then he looks to you guys and goes, "What? Why didn't you help? I
walk over to him and like, "Well, guards probably got to him before he bled out. You did not take a life today. Try to help console him."
Yeah. Yeah, a dagger wound's not fatal, right? There's that can be fixed. Not everyone dies from being stabbed.
Yeah, a guard got to him in time.
They were calling something awful back there. Certainly a guard must have... Yeah. Okay.
Kind of give him a pat of reinsurance.
Okay.
He
starts leading the way through the alleyway back to your establishment.
Yeah. Do we get a chance to divide up the jewels?
Yes. David doesn't seem to want to do it right now.
Okay.
He wants to push on.
All right. So we just push on and go back to the establishment, I guess.
You get back to the bar. This sort of place is open late. In fact, it doesn't even open until late.
Mm-hmm.
So here you are. same shitty musicians are playing the same crappy song.
Yep. I'll probably walk up to the magicians and give them a silver tip just to give them a nod. Play it loud and proud.
All right. And they do so.
Okay. As we, I'm looking for probably a table close to the magicians so that our talking is hushed by the music.
Sure. You find it.
Okay.
The sort of place is not always all that busy.
So, we gonna make this a regular thing between us three?
Jeff goes, yeah, I'm in. That was great. Like, what, 10 minutes of work? Maybe half an hour of work considering walking time? And I can live on this for a month.
There we go.
2 months, we'll wait. Make it stretch.
We'll wait till the heat dies down a little bit, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
How does David look with his...
He's ordered like a triple whiskey and is just kind of shaking and drinking.
Mm-hmm.
Quiet.
So let's hope next time there isn't a guard, David. I kind of give him a pat on the back.
Yeah. You said it was just going to be a scared little girl, right?
I didn't see any guard while I was there. Even with the information I had, we got out pretty well.
Jeff pipes in. Oh, don't worry. He was old anyway. He was about to die from old age. I mean, did you see the wrinkles on his face? The guy must have been 100. Don't worry about it, man. He wasn't worth anything.
Little girl is scary with a crossbow, though.
Yeah. Well, still, all's well that ends well, right? Right? Right?
Yeah. I'd like to get one of the prettiest gems, one of the most finished ones,
mm-hmm.
and just give it to David as his first payment.
Okay.
You get first choice on the loot.
He takes it just kind of absentmindedly, like he's not really following the conversation, and just mm-hmm. holds it in his hand, kind of rolling it back and forth while he stares into his cup.
Okay. So I think that's a night for our group after we finish drinking and split it up.
All right, you finish all the drinking, split up the loot, and mm-hmm. everyone eventually heads back to their homes.
Okay, so what can I mark down for the loot?
So it was what, 27 gold divided among 3 people? So that's 9 gold each. Well, 9 gold worth of jewelry that you can probably only sell for 6 mm-hmm. gold.
All right, I put it as unfinished gems,
yeah.
So I know what it is.
Yeah.
Okay, so I probably head back to my house.
All right, you get back to your house, and you can pass out for the night.
Okay. Probably wake up. I probably sleep in like super late. I just had a good score. Everything's going good in the world. I deserve to sleep in. Okay, so I'll probably get up probably 1, maybe noon, like pretty late.
Okay.
And is my house in the slums or is it in the...
Near the slums, you know.
Okay.
You're in the projects, not the slums.
Okay. So I'll probably get my... what do I want to do next? Yeah, I'll head to, I'll put my fancy clothes on and head through the nice neighborhood. Mm-hmm. Trying to stay maybe not too far. I might want to get a peek at the jewelry place, but not walking next to it.
Mm-hmm.
Do I see any guards there? What do I see going on about?
You see a locksmith working on the handle on the doorknob. He's taken it mostly apart and is currently cleaning it with a little brush with metal whiskers.
There we go. Okay.
The woman from yesterday with the frazzled hair steps out She looks like she hasn't slept all night, and she's kind of pacing back and forth, watching him work.
Making sure it gets... All right. So, with the lords in the town, how does that work? Is there, like, minor lords in town, or is it just rich people, or how does...
There are wealthy people, and there are... So you've got your upper class, your noble class, and you've got your, like, wealthy merchants, and mm-hmm. you've got your skilled workers, and you've got, like, you know, the whole social hierarchy, and they're all fairly well represented here. Some lords do prefer to live on the lands that they own, while others prefer to live in town and have people manage their lands for them. Yeah. So those that live in town tend to be a little bit more on the lazy side.
Yeah. I'd like to head to maybe one of the wealthy houses.
Roll me a perception check real quick.
Yeah. That's not perception, I think it's 8. Yeah. 15.
Ooh, no dice. All right. You start heading into the wealthier section of town. What are you wearing for clothes?
I'm wearing my fancy green outfit.
Okay.
With my canvas and all my painting stuff with me.
All right. Sure. You're walking through this nicer part of town. Easy peasy.
Yep. I'd like to look for a wealthy house, but not, preferably not two stories. Maybe a one-story house.
Okay. Those are going to be a little harder to find, but you do find one behind a wall. It's got its own, like, walled-in private estate. You can see through the gate, there's, like, a nice stone path through a lush lawn filled with rose bushes and various plants and a little pool that has fish in it and a swan floating on it. There's a little stone bridge that the path leads over until you get to the front of the house. Mm-hmm. And you see a halfling gardener bent over near the pond, kind of digging in the ground, planting something.
Is the gate closed, or is it like an iron gate with a stone
It is
wall?
It's a stone wall with an iron gate that is quite see-through. You know, it's just like fancy bars in a nice pattern. The gate is not actually all that high.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's not like if the walls are 10 feet, the gate is only like 8 feet. It does have spikes on the top, though.
It does have spikes?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'd like to stand at the gate and wave at the gardener.
Takes a while for the gardener to notice you, but eventually he does and comes on over to say hi.
You said it was a halfling?
Yep.
Trying to think of a rhyme.
No, gnomes rhyme.
Gnomes rhyme, okay, yeah. Okay. So is the Mr. home?
Yes, sir, but who's asking?
My name is Benjamin. I am a artist. I'd want to know if he would like his portrait done.
Gardner looks a little overwhelmed with the duty of having to relay this sort of information. He goes, please wait here. He just turns and scurries off into the house.
Okay.
A few minutes later, one of those, you know, proud footmen, like a English butler, or not butlers, but footmen, you know, that comes out with the nice clothes, wearing the tuxedo and the bow tie and the nice black buttons, walks over to the gate and kind of looks down his nose at you. Yes, sir?
Hello. I am a artist, and I would like to paint a portrait.
Very well.
Is this the lord, or is it a footman?
This is a footman, yeah. He's just...
May I see the mister?
I do not think we are requiring any painters today. Thank you.
Well, tell him that I stopped by, please.
Yes, sir.
Kind of give him a tip of my hat and do like a turn where I'm on my heel as I turn around.
You turn and the footman watches you walk away.
I pretty much just walk to the next fancy house.
Okay.
Probably in eyesight of him so he can be like, okay, he went. That's what he's doing.
Okay.
So I go up to the next fancy house.
Mm-hmm.
Kind of probably cursing under my breath because of the beautiful garden I could have painted with the Lord in it. So I head up to the next fancy house. What does it look like?
This is a two-story house, again, behind a stone wall. There aren't gardens in front. Instead, you've kind of got nice trees, and you notice a hammock on the side. Mm-hmm. And there are a trio of people digging a trench kind of to the side of the house behind the hammock a little bit.
Mm-hmm. The people digging the trench just look like manual labor people.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. You said they're building them, like, on the other side of the wall, or where are they building the trench at?
So if you look through the gate, back towards mm-hmm. the house, on the to the right, on the side of the house between the house and the wall that surrounds the whole property is where they're digging the trench. And the hammock is a little bit before that and a little closer to the gate, so further from the wall.
I peek up my voice. Good day. I was wondering if the mister is home?
One of the laborers comes over towards you and goes, no, no, none of them home right now. Just the servants.
Well, can you relay a message for me?
Yeah.
I'd like tell him that Benjamin, the artist, is in and he's looking for another beautiful face to paint.
All right, we'll tell him. He know where to find you?
I give him the name of one of the fancier taverns.
All right. Will do.
Okay. Do I see anybody walking down the street?
Yeah, there is a horse-drawn carriage coming your way.
I go up to the horse-drawn carriage.
Okay.
Hello, my lord.
What's your reaction adjust on your charisma? In fact, why don't you just make me a charisma check? That's way easier.
20.
He stops the carriage. And looks at you quizzically. Yes?
Would you like a portrait done?
No, I have enough portraits, thank you.
Okay. And he probably just rides off.
Yep.
Okay. So I turn and go to one of the fancy inn that I told the guy about. What is the fancy inn like? And what's...
The fancy tavern, or inn, whatever it is three stories made out of all wood and just kind of very well carved. Lots of time and effort was put into the craftsmanship here.
Mm-hmm. I walk up to the, probably like a bartender or whoever's like works there.
Mm-hmm. Sure. You step up, the bartender looks over to see you.
Hello, my kind sir.
Hi, how's it going?
My name is Benjamin, and I stick out my hand for a handshake.
He shakes it and goes back to polishing his cup.
I have told people that I'd be here. I'm going to be out upon the town, and if they come ask for me when I come back, can you tell me they came and asked for me?
He nods. Of course. Mm.
I give him a tip of like 5 silver, probably.
All right, he takes it, gives you a smile, Where do you go?
Tell them Benjamin will be at their house in the morning.
Will do.
Okay. So I give him a nod and I probably head back to my house.
Okay. Are you there for the rest of the day?
I'll probably change back and head back to the Shady Inn.
Okay. You find your two friends back at the tavern. Hanging out.
I go back down and sit with them. How's David doing today?
Really jittery.
Jittery?
Really jittery. He looks super nervous and just uncomfortable.
So, David, I took a peek at the jeweler's place. You'd be happy to know I didn't see any priests or anyone in there performing a funeral. I believe that the person made it out pretty scathed. I believe I even saw him walking about in there.
He nods. Yeah. He gets up at the start and looks around and goes, I gotta go for a walk, guys. And then he just turns and walks for the front door, shaking his head as he goes.
I turn to Jeffrey. Has it been like that all day?
A little bit. When David gets to the door, he opens it, starts to step outside, and then like looks back at you guys with like the saddest look in his eyes. Because I'm so sorry. And then you see a hand on his shoulder pulling him away as two armed guards step into the room and start moving in your direction.
What's around me?
First off, initiative roll. But you're in a tavern. It's pretty shady and sketchy. Lots of tables, a small stage in a corner, a bartender, maybe a dozen patrons.
Six.
All right, there are two guards. And you have your one friend with you.
Okay. Are we at the corner seat by the musicians like I had last night?
No, these guys were in the center of the room.
The center of the room. Do I go first or does Jeffrey?
Jeffrey goes first. He rolled a one. He gets up and he bolts for the back door immediately.
It's probably where I follow him as I run.
Okay. The guards go before you can get out of your chair, though. They went at 2 and 3. Jeffrey went at 1. So you got screwed here. That's a 6, right? Yeah. All right. So the guards with their... seems like they've left their pole arms outside. They've got short swords drawn. And they step to you with the short swords. Not like I'm about to stab you, but just in a... we've got you here, and they surround you quickly. Well, one of them surrounds you. One of them comes to you. One of them chases Jeff out the back door, actually.
So, what's the problem?
You're wanted for murder.
I kind of look back and forth at my waist. Did I leave my knife in my side?
Wherever it normally is.
I probably just came from the richer neighborhood, so I'm going to say it's in my bag.
Okay.
With what? My words?
He takes his free hand and grabs you by the back of your shirt and hauls you out of your chair.
Hey, be easy. As he kind of pulls me and starts probably dragging me out.
Yeah. He sheathes his sword and starts kind of marching you while still holding onto your collar. You see David outside being held by another guard, just shaking his head. When you get hauled out, the one guard lets go of David and tells him to scram, and he starts to run off.
So I hold my hands up. I have 4 cons, so I probably weigh a stick, so he pretty much carries me out. Mm-hmm. And I stand there with the guards until they tell me to do something. Do they ever let go of me or anything?
One of them keeps a hand on the back of your shirt and starts to march you. At first, you're not sure where, but then it becomes very obvious that he's taking you to their jail cells.
Okay. Is it just one guard beside me? Is the other one still back at the bar? Or?
Yeah, it's just the one marching you.
Okay, and he just has a grip on my back of my shirt. Mm-hmm. Well, what? I didn't steal anything as I turned to him.
You're not wanted for theft. You're wanted for murder.
Who did I kill? Is I?
Tim Bones.
Do I know that name? Probably not.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. What are we walking past?
Kind of like the middle class of town.
Okay. Is there people walking about the streets or?
Uh-huh. But there's a lot of people looking at you as the guard walks down the street holding you by your collar. Everyone's eyes are on you guys.
Everyone's eyes are on
me. Oh yeah, you get all sorts of hecklers calling at you. People spitting at you. Someone throws a tomato at you.
Do I see any other guards walking about the town?
No. You don't pass any guards yet. You probably will once you get closer to the place.
Probably whenever I see an opportunity, I'm gonna try to, I guess, a strength check to try to break free.
All right. When are you gonna consider an opportunity?
If I see like a crowd of people around a well, like some small children or something that I could like run through. So if he tried to run through him, he'll knock him over.
Okay.
So he'd have to like take an alternate route.
Sure. Roll me an opposed strength check.
Let's hope for a 20.
Ooh,
22.
You wrench free of his grip.
I'd like to bolt through the children or whatever I saw.
All right, you bolt through the children. The guard yells out, "Stop, thief, murderer!" As you run. There are a few people around. I'm going to say one of them tries to tackle you. That is a miss. He goes for a tackle and misses as you bolt down a road. The guard pushes after you, bowling over the children, not even giving a crap about them, and begins to chase you between the tall, multi-story buildings.
Super tall buildings?
Yeah.
As I run through the street, if there's like the barrels of water or anything, I'd like to try to throw them behind me as I run.
Sure. Make a strength check, but if you fail your strength check, it actually slows you down.
Slows me down. How far back is he? Is he just like right on my tail?
Yeah.
20 feet. All right, I'm gonna go for a strength check. Is it, what am I trying to throw over? Just a barrel of water?
Yeah, big barrel of water.
Yes.
Nice, you grab a barrel and toss it down. It cracks and splits. Sending water everywhere, but also the barrel's still, you know, there. Mm-hmm. The guard does his best to leap over it and through the water. Slips when he lands, and kind of his feet go out from underneath him. You hear a crack as he hits the ground hard. Mm-hmm. And moments later, you're gone between two alleys and out of danger.
Okay. I'd like to head to my house once I get a chance. Mm-hmm. Change into my green outfit, maybe shave if I have a little bit of stubble growing. Try to do something to shave. Probably shave parts of, like, change my luscious brown hair, probably cut it in some bits, make it a shortcut. Mm-hmm. As I go to the nice inn.
Okay. You find yourself at the nice inn a little bit later.
As I go in, do I see the person that I tipped to tell me if anybody came by?
Yep. He's still standing there. He's kind of a large barrel-chested man polishing some ale glasses.
Do I have any jobs for today?
Sorry, son. No one came by.
All right, then, as I look about the bar, do I see, like, any...
All manner of wealthy people.
Is there people up playing on their like instruments or anything?
Yep. There's a trio of musicians.
Okay. I'd go to set up my painting station probably somewhere close to them, mm-hmm. and kind of facing the bar, mm-hmm. like facing like the whole crowd of people. Mm-hmm. And I put down my hat in front of it and I just start painting like the whole bar scene.
All right. All right. I think that's where we're probably going to end for today. I don't think there's any other trouble we can get into that we can get out of in time.
Okay.
So we'll call that our audition for today. Good job. Well played. It's a couple lucky rolls in there, but yeah. I think that more than makes up for the terrible stats and HP that you rolled.
Yeah, at least I didn't die.
Well, that's good.
Mm-hmm.
So thanks for playing. I'll be making some notes here in a little bit.
Okay.
And sit tight. You won't hear from me until close to the end of the month. So no news is good news.
All right. I want to thank you for having me on.
My pleasure. You're a lot of fun to play with. I liked your approach of the rogue. The sort of guy who scouts out deals and doesn't necessarily do them himself. It was good.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Novel. Right. Do you have any final words for people watching before we sign off?
Wish me luck.
All right. That's it, guys. Right. We will see you later. Bye-bye.